or matching, something like that.
Get a candle with a cup.
Or if you don't have a cup, put some cup in it.
We are going to pray in the last 5 minutes to 12 midnight. Our candles will come on, and we are going to enter into the new year with the light. God bless you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We bless you, Lord. We worship you. How many of you are excited to get into the new year? Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I want to thank everybody that came today. And those of you watching online, it has been a very rocky year. Many times I will be here by myself, like this time here, every day, like when this couple walked in, and Brother Peters and the wife, they said they go to the church, they said there's a church right in front of us, and they looked for the church and they came, knocked at the door, and I came out. I told them we just finished. But actually, I just finished doing my life, and they walked in, and we came here and prayed. You say, wow, we didn't know there's a church here. But thank God for Google, because we are visible. They typed church and our church came out, God's Time Assembly. And Amen. They came down here. Hallelujah. Amen. A lot of people have come here like that. There was one guy who was a pastor also. He came and he was living somewhere here. He said he was looking for a church. And Google brought him here. He came and worshiped with us before he moved down south. And I still communicate with him today. So God is helping us to advertise us by himself. In the name of Jesus Christ. Today, what the Lord gave me for us for 2022 is a new season is coming your way. Amen. God said, I will do a new thing. Hallelujah. Amen. So I want you to know that 2022 is your year of new things. Amen. It will begin in this January. Amen. It shall begin in January. Yes. In the name of Jesus. Amen. New things will begin to happen for you. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. You are not excited. Something new. Forget about the old things. God is about to do something new. And say it will happen in this month. Yeah. And every month till December, yeah, you shall experience a new life. Amen. A life that is full of abundance. Yeah. A life that is worth living. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. Lord, the Bible said the entrance of the world giveth light and understanding to the simple. Lord, your word is a lamp unto our feet. And the light unto our path. Let the word that we shall hear and speak now, yeah, not be an enticing word of a man, but let it be the word of God that will bring glory to thy holy name. Yeah. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Yeah. Oh, Yakaraba. We are going to pray with the word. If you have your Bible, open the book of Psalm 121. If you don't have, just read with us. Hallelujah. Psalm 121. That's the first stop today. So the word for us is new season, new thing. Psalm 121, verse 1 and 2. Oh, la karaba shikataba. Ezekiel is not on the computer today because he has to do something. Are we there? Verse 1, he said, I will lift up my eyes to where? To the hills. From whence cometh my help? The Bible says, my help comes from the Lord who made the heaven and earth. We are serving a God that is a maker. Begin to pray. Say, Lord, make me today. As I look up to the hills, make something new happen in my life. Amen. Let something tangible happen in my life. The Bible says, I will lift up my eyes unto the hill. From whence cometh my help? Yes. My help comes from not my father. Woo! My help does not come from the American government. My help is not coming from a man, but from the Lord, the one that makes the heaven and the earth. Yeah. Lord, make something happen for me. Yeah. Begin to pray that prayer. My help comes from the Lord. The Lord that made the heaven and the earth. Right now, let help come from me. Let the help come. Let God begin to send helpers. Lord, help me. Help me, oh Lord. Right now, in the name of Jesus, let the help of God come upon my life. Help me today by the power and the authority. In the name of Jesus, help me, oh Lord. Lebo go soko tomo yika na ba 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 ba. Makata na ba yika na ma shiko tomo. Rekata na ba yika na ba 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 ba. Makoro go soko tomo ba ba. Yekata na ba shakata ba. In the name of Jesus Christ. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2. Hallelujah. Amen. Ola ba 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 shikata na ba. Bear with me. We are going to get down to this. As much as we can. It's a lot of prayers I wrote down here. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2. I read first chapter 2. Verse 18.
Amen. Oh, la Baba. The Bible says, therefore, are we there? Amen. Let's read together. He said, therefore, we wanted to come to you. Even I, Paul was telling them, time and again. But what? But Satan hindered us. Anyone that is Satan has hindered this year, today God is going to fight your battle.
Amen.
He said, we wanted to come to you. That means they have the desire, they have the will, they have the capacity. Time and again, they couldn't come because Satan hindered them. Every power that have hindered you from getting something today, we break it. We break it. Begin to pray. Paul said, this is a man of God. He said, we wanted to come to you. We tried to come to you. We tried to minister to you. We tried to help you. But Satan held us. Today, every satanic power, every Luciferian power, every authority from the old, every power from anywhere that have hindered me, we break it. We come against you by the power and the authority. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, every power from the pit of hell, the Bible said, and hinder us, it cannot hinder me. Today, every spirit of hindrance, we break you now, we come against you in the name of Jesus. Verse 13 to 15. And Moses said to the people, do not be afraid. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians which you have seen today, you shall see again, no more forever. The Lord will what? Fight your battles. And you shall what? Call their peace. In verse 15. And the Lord said to Moses, why do you cry to me? Why do you cry to me? He said, tell the children of Israel that what? They go forward. From today, begin to go forward. Begin to go forward. Begin to go forward. In the name of Jesus, the Lord shall fight your battle. And you shall hold your peace. You shall move forward. You shall go forward. You shall go forward. You shall go forward. You shall go forward. Forward ever. Backward never. You shall go forward from today. Go forward. Go forward. Go forward. Go forward. Go forward. Go forward. Begin to go forward. In the spirit, go forward. In the physical, go forward. You shall not be stuck. Everything that will keep you back, we are stuck you now. We won't be followed. By the power and the authority in Jesus' mighty name. 1 Samuel chapter 12, verse 6. 1 Samuel 12, verse 6. You can be writing it if you can open it, but just follow us. The Bible says, then Samuel said to the people, as I'm saying to you right now, it is the Lord who raised up Moses and Aaron and who brought forth your fathers up to the land of Egypt. I like the translation that says, it is the Lord that advanced. Who have that translation? It is the Lord that advanced Aaron and Moses. Nobody can advance you. Say, God, advance me today. Samuel told the people, say, it is the Lord who advanced Aaron and Moses and your fathers. Lord, advance me today. Move me forward. Advance me. Lord, advance me. Lord, advance me. As you did to Moses and Aaron, advance me today. Take me forward. Carry me to the height where I'm supposed to go. Nebaga shakataba, makataraba sikataba, hibaga shakataba nikolomo, rebababa rikanaba sikataba, makitaraba lokoto shokotomo, neketereba rikanaba mama, makitaraba rikanaba shikataba, lokoto shokotomo yekanaba mama, makitaraba shikataba mama, nebaga shikotomo, makaraba rikanaba, makaraba rikanaba, rabababa, rabababa, rabababa. Baba Lande, 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 Baba Lande Psalm 45. Oh, Yagaraba. Verse 12. The Bible said here, and the daughter of Tyre will come with what? Gift.
Yes.
A rich among the people will seek your favor.
Yes.
The daughter of the king, the nobles, the presidents, they will begin to look for you with gift.
Amen.
They will begin to seek you with gift.
Amen.
And not only will they bring you, they will be looking for your favor.
Amen.
Because when they connect with you, they have connected to blessings. Begin to pray. Let the daughter of Tyre, whether they are in the spirit or in the physical, begin to look for me with gift.
Amen.
Let them begin to seek me with gift. Let them begin to seek me with gift. Let them begin to seek me with gift now. Let every king, every royalty, every position person, every influential person, let them begin to look for me. Seek me now with gift by the power and the authority. Let them seek me with gift. Let them seek me with gift. Let the daughter of Tyre come after me. Let them seek for me. Let them come with a gift. Let them come with a gift. Let them come with a gift. The rich among the people will seek my favor. The rich among the society. The rich among the noble. The rich among the people. They shall seek my favor by the power and the authority. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. We are warming up now. Isaiah chapter 61, verse 5. Are we there? Isaiah 61, verse 5. The Bible said, strangers shall stand and feed your flocks. Strangers are going to be feeding your flock. And look at verse 7. Verse 6. And the sons of foreigners shall be your plowmen and your wine dressers. I like the translation that says aliens. Strangers. You know, many of us are used to people, our family members blessing us, our father, our mother, our pastor, somebody we know, our brother, our uncle, our job. So we are used to a particular place for blessings. But God said this time, it's people you don't know.
Amen.
Strangers shall begin to stand and feed their flocks. Your blessing will not come from where you know about. Bless you since you don't know. And God said not only strangers will come, you will bring foreigners.
Hallelujah.
Foreigners will begin to walk in your farm and be your wine dresser. Begin to pray. Let strangers bless me. Let foreigners bless me. Let strangers bless me. Let foreigners bless me. Today, by the power and the authority, let my blessing come from strangers. Come from people I don't know. People I have never seen. By the power and the authority, people I have not done anything for, they shall be a blessing to me. Strangers shall bless me. Foreigners will bless me. By the power and the authority, they shall work for me. Strangers will work for me. Foreigners will begin to work for me. Today, Lord, enlighten my course. Take me to the height. By the power and the authority, in the name of Jesus. Magere barakatarama. Beketele banikaraba sikotomo. Lebrobo shokotomo ikaranamama. Makitarama nikolobo sokotomo. In the name of Jesus Christ. Because of time, we are running now. Joel chapter 2. Verse 25, many of us are used to this place. We are going to recover everything. I don't care what you have lost this year. What you have lost, as long as you have lived. If you have lived 50 years, everything you have lost for 50 years, God is giving you back.
Amen.
Joel 2:25. Are we there? The Bible says, oh, it says, so I will what? Restore to you. When God wants to give, you see, sometimes, I don't want to preach. In Isaiah 38, you remember when the king Hezekiah was sick and he was praying for healing. And the prophet came and made it worse, told him that God said, you are dying. You will die. Put the house in order. When the prophet left, the man, the king, turned to the wall where he has written what he had done as God commanded him. He said, God, I did this. I did that. I did this. I did that. The Lord said, please. Go and tell him that I've added 15 more years. What the devil steals from us is time. Everything God will give you, God will give you time to recover it.
Amen.
Sometimes when you lose money, you say, God, give me that money back. No. God will give you time to make more than that.
Amen.
The Bible said, I will restore. Look at what God is saying in the story. Not money, not house, because if he gives you time, you will get all those. He said, I will restore to you the years that the swindling locust has eaten up, the crawling locust has eaten up, the consuming locust and the crawling locust, my great army which I sent among you, I will restore. Say, God, restore years to me. Restore years to me. Restore years to me. Restore years. As long as you have years, you have years. If you have time, you will recover. It doesn't matter whatever you have lost. If you have time, you will recover. God will give you time back. But the Lord shall give you time. He will restore years. Years that the power has eaten up for you. Recovery. You are recovering years now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, yeah. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. Now God is going to give you speed. When God gives you years and gives you speed, you get it all. Isaiah chapter 40. Look at verse 31. Many of us are used to that place. Isaiah chapter 40. Verse 31, the Bible says, but then I wait upon the Lord. You know, some of us are supposed to be in our bed now, but we decided to come to church. He said, but then I wait upon the Lord. They shall what? To renew their strength. And what happened? They shall mount up with wings as an eagle. Some of you are ready to fly. You are going to fly. Let me tell you, in this kingdom, we fly faster than witches. You can be here and see what is happening in Washington D.C. When God begins to carry you in the eagle's wing, distance will not be a problem. He said, you shall mount up with me as an eagle. You shall run and not be weary. You shall walk and not faint. That is anointing for speed. Everything that has delayed you, everything you have lost, God is giving you speed. What you couldn't do in 10 years, you will do in 1 month. What you couldn't do in years, you shall do in months. By the power and the authority, let the anointing for speed come upon you. Lord, I will run and not be weary. I shall walk and not faint. Restore my strength. The Lord shall add strength to me. As I wait upon you, Lord, you shall increase my strength. You shall renew my strength. You shall renew my strength. I will begin to mount up with wings as an eagle in the name of Jesus Christ. Esther chapter 6. Esther chapter 6. I don't know whether we are going to do this. The time is of essence. I want to cover some ground. Esther chapter 6, are we there? Let's just read 1, 2, 3 fast. The Bible says in verse 6, verse 1, Esther chapter 6, the night the king could not sleep. So one of the commanders to bring the book of record and chronicle, and they were read before the king. Verse 2, and it was found written that Mordecai had told the Bigtan and Teresh, two of the king's eunuch, the doorkeepers, who had sought to lay hand on the king and his sons. And verse 3, then the king said, what honor and dignity has been bestowed on Mordecai for this? Somebody will not sleep until they honor him. The king will not sleep. Because God decided to honor somebody. I said, many of you are just walking. You don't know what you have done in the past. You have even forgotten about it. Honor is coming. Honor and dignity. Two things are coming at the same time. The Bible said the king put us in the same, begin to read for me. And they were reading. The king was walking around until he heard that somebody has saved his life. He said, what honor and dignity have been done? He said, nothing. He said, really? Begin to do it now. Begin to do it now. I said, the Lord will bless you in haste. I said, honor and dignity. Somebody is remembering you. You shall be remembered. You shall be remembered. The Bible said, and the Lord remembered Jacob. And the Lord remembered Noah. And the Lord remembered Samuel. And the Lord remembered David. Today, God has remembered you. In the name of Jesus Christ. A book book of remembrance have been opened. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. There are four group of people you need. We might not read all of them. Divine connectors. People that will connect you to your destiny. If you look at 2 Kings chapter 5, the slave girl that was taken in Israel, and he was taken into slavery in the house of the general. And when the general was leprous, the guy said, "My Lord, there is a prophet in my country that can heal this man." And he told to the wife. The wife told the general. The general said, "What?" They got a letter and they came to Elisha. Elisha said, "Go to Judah." That lady was a divine connector. Sometimes the people that will connect you to your person, they don't have anything to give to you. That's why you have to be discerning. It's not everybody that must bless you. But some people have the information that give you money. Some people are the ones that will tell you there is a job in this place. They cannot get that job, but you can get it. They will just give you the connection. And when you go, your job will come. Let my divine connectors come. Let them begin to come right now. By the power and the authority. In the name of Jesus. Everyone that will connect me. By the power and authority. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Genesis 41 verse 14. You can write it. We will not read it. When Pharaoh had a dream and could not interpret the dream, the guy that Joseph served in prison, the baker and the butler, the baker was killed. The butler has forgotten about it. 2 years have passed. But let it be when the king would not get an answer. Men of influence will begin to remember you. That guy was when they were discussing. He said, there is somebody in the prison that will give us the answer. Immediately the Pharaoh sent for Joseph in Genesis 41. And Joseph was called, and that was the end of famine in that land. Joseph gave them the wisdom to save food for 7 years.
Yes.
Let men of influence remember you.
Yes.
Men of influence will remember you.
Yes.
People that are in places where things are being discussed, they will say, "Oh, there's a sister, there's a brother, there's somebody I met. I saw him walking there." We can call him, he will give us answer. By the power and the authority, in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You need men that have gifts also. In every endeavor that God has put in your life, you need people that are gifted. The Bible says the gift of the man make it way for them and bring them before great men. So in Ephesians chapter 4, 11, many of us know, the Bible says the Spirit gave them some apostles and some preachers and some pastors, some evangelists, some what's it called? Teachers. And the last one is some prophets to the edifying. Let men with gift begin to follow you. Because when you have people that have gift, the job will be easy. It's not just enough to have people, but to have people that have gift. People that are gifted. People that have gift in them. Because the gift of a man will make a way. Let men and women that have gift begin to locate you now. By the power and the authority, can we put on our lights? Can we put on our lights? In the name of Jesus, let's put on our lights. Even if we don't finish the prayers, put on your lights. Put on your light. Your light will shine this year. In the name of Jesus Christ, God will also give you burden bearers, men that has burden in them, by the power and the authority. Who has a candle, a light? Just come and put my light for me on here. A matches or something? Oh, yeah, you need a candle. They'll give you one. Tell me, where's the candle? If you don't have a candle, raise your hand up. That is it here. Get one candle. If you don't have a candle, take one. Yeah, that's all of it. Put it on. Off the light. Oh, yes. Your candles are on. Let's switch off the light. We are going to pray with one verse that is on the screen. Oh, yakara baba baba. Get your light on. You have a candle? Let's stand on here. Ezekiel, give the candles.
that thing out. Pull the wax out. Okay, you have it. Please help us. Please help your friend. Help somebody. Oh, yes, Lord. We are waiting for the new year. If we are in new year already, hallelujah. Up the light, please. Up the light. We must light our light into the new year. Our light must shine into the new year. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. The word for us this year is Isaiah 43. It's on the screen. Isaiah 43, verse 18 and 19. The Bible says, remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of the old. For behold, I will do what? A new thing. And now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. A new thing is happening in your life. Your light will not go off. Your light shall not go off. Like the six, like the five fruit veggies, your life went out when the master came. Your light will not go off. Lift your light up. Lift it up. Lift it up. Your light must shine by the power and the authority in the name of Jesus. Your light will shine. This year, your candle will continue to shine. Your light will never go off. It will not go off. It will not go off. Your light will not quench. This year, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, and December 2022. Your light will be on. Your light will be on. Wonderful one indeed. And don't leave. When we finish, we're going to share the grace. We have food.